Hey, what's going on, you guys? Depdoc here. Welcome back to another episode of me reviewing a movie or a show. This episode, we are going to be doing Army of the Dead. This movie came out yesterday, and I'm here to review it. I'm going to talk about the good, the bad, and what I honestly thought about the movie. But before I get into it, I really appreciate if you guys would please leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more of these videos that come in the future. I know it's been a minute since I've actually recorded another one of these, and I know I missed yesterday, but they'll be a video tomorrow, I promise you guys that. And just like liking the video just tells me you guys want to see more of these videos, because I'm just trying to figure out what content you guys like to see. And here's your daily meme.
7 a.m. Good morning. It's about to be this is so much better than therapy. 9 a.m. Let's see what this one says. Hydrate yourself. It gets better every single sip. Excuse me, I think I have to use the little boy's room. 11 a.m. It just doesn't stop. Fuck! Remember your goal! 1 p.m. When will it stop? There's piss everywhere!
There you go. All right, so let's hop right into this. All right, so the premise and the point of the movie of Army of the Dead is basically a group of people that, well, the world gets hit by the zombie pandemic thanks to an Area 51 outbreak of a package. Basically, this it can spread like just normal zombies like The Walking Dead does through bite transmission, through that. So basically, the idea is to lock off the city so that no one can get into it. But there's a guy who's a really rich billionaire who owns a casino who asked this guy who was a fighter, also played by Depdoc, who was a fighter in the war of keeping people safe and actually survived the attack, comes to him and asks him to make a team to break into a casino to make a ton of money. They build a team up and they head to the casino to see if they can run into to get the money from the vault. We run into some certain problems. I'm not going to go into them problems because that would be spoiling the movie and I really don't want to. But I want to talk about my honest opinions about the movie. Number one, the movie looked awesome. The movie, I honestly loved the movie. It was, like, really good to watch. It was a good action movie. There was a few down parts, but when the down parts were happening, it was more of a, is funny or something interesting was going on. I like some of the main characters. They show a lot of character and a lot of, they build each other up in some points. And it's just really interesting to see what they're doing most of the time. They all have, like, their certain kind of roles. Like, some people are gunners, some people go after the vault, some people are on the other side of the mission, like, trying to figure out the zombies. Because the zombies have, like, a big, giant part of arc. I didn't think they would, but they do. And that arc is, like, kind of really important for, like, most of the movie. Because, like, when we think about zombies, we think about brainless beings that don't know what the heck they're doing. But I was surprised when watching this movie, when that actually isn't always true. Now, I really do like the premise, and honestly, like, it is made by Zack Snyder, the same guy who made the Justice League 4-hour cut of his ideal movie for that movie, ideal look of the movie. So basically, you're gonna get a really dark and feel-good movie, and the thing that makes it feel good, like, it makes it feel like a good movie is that it doesn't feel cliche and it does not feel like, oh, yay, happiness. Like, you're gonna really see, like, a lot of, like, downtime with characters, and you're really gonna see, like, how, like, the past really impacts everything, because it's not like it's taken, like, from a point to be like, hey, the past don't matter. No, the past really does matter about a lot of parts of this movie and stuff like that. So that's something that's also involved with a lot of things. But I do want to talk about the parts I did not really like about the movie. The number one thing I really didn't like about the movie is that it just seems like some of the characters are just there to die. And it's really sad to say that when, like, they're just there for something. It reminds me of The Last of Us Part 2, when basically they take something like a character growth and then just immediately kill them off. Like, nothing. Like, it doesn't even matter. Like, they don't even matter. And it really does suck. And you're like, wow, what the heck? And the point of everything with that movie is just that it's I don't know. It just, I don't really like characters just instantly dying. I don't see a point about that. I don't see anything. Now, the characters that deserve the things they do, like, they get it. Like, the more dark, evil characters part of the movie. Because there's no real villain, per se. But there's a lot of, like, scummy people in the movie. But overall, it's a good action flick film to watch with family. Well, not really a family movie, but to watch with friends. Just friends, adults to watch this movie. It has a lot of blood, a bit of cussing, and it has a lot of, like, crude humor, but it is a good movie. Now, what do I rank this movie? I rank it about a 78. Or maybe an 80. I'll give it an 80. Not saying it's a bad movie. Just saying, like, it's very cliche. And if it comes down to a point to where if you're not, like, Zack Snyder's, like, film preference, because there's a lot of, like, slow motion moving, like, how there was in Justice League, because there was a lot of slow motion movement in Justice League, which I know for a fact not a lot of people liked. So it's more of that, and I want to be, like, more equal with myself, because number one, I will probably not go back to watching this movie, not because I hate it, just because it's not really memorable, and if I do go back to it, it's just because another friend wants to watch it. But yeah, guys, that's my opinions on this movie. I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more videos like these to come soon. Hopefully, I actually have the next one planned, which is going to be Who Killed Sarah Season 2, because that recently came out, and I was like, wait, what? It's already out. I'm going to watch that. I'm going to start watching it soon, and I'll have it up for you guys probably next week to do a review on it. So yeah, guys, I'll see you guys then. See you guys later.